In this beginner Python exercise, we'll be going over the steps of creating a script to animate the location property of a cube. And if you stick around, I'll share with you a couple of exercises to solidify your knowledge. Hi, I'm Victor Stepanov. I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python exercise. Today, we'll be animating a cube's location. It's going to be a simple script, so let's get straight into it. I'm going to open Blender and go into scripting workspace. Since we'll be working on an animation, we need to see the timeline. So I'm going to open a timeline right underneath the viewport. I'm going to modify this. Also, I'll set the frames to 180. And I will set the frame rate in this output right here to 30. Like so. And let's just modify this a bit so we can see all the frames. Perfect. All right. Before we start, we need to think through what exactly we plan to do, right? So think through the steps of what it would take to do this by hand to add a simple location animation for a cube. While you think through that, I'll start typing in the steps that I would take when I would be doing this. So I would go up here and click new in the text editor and add the comments of the steps that I would take. All right, I've written down the comments in the script, and I'm using this hash character in front of each line right here, so Python doesn't see it. So I can use just plain English and write down what I'm thinking about to do in this particular line, right? So I'm just gonna run the script and show you that nothing will change. So nothing will change in the scene, the outliner, and anywhere in Blender, right? This is just this to Blender, this or to Python, this looks like this, right? So it doesn't see any of that text. It's only here for us. So the first thing that we need to do is to import BPY. So as Blender has add-ons, Python also has a type of add-on called the module, right? So it extends the ability, Python's ability to do something, right? In this particular case, we're extending Python to be able to press Blender's buttons. So this is exactly what we'll do now. So that's import BPY. Next, we'll need to add a cube into the scene. And I'm just going to hover over the 3D viewport and hit A, X, and then delete. And that's going to delete everything from my scene. And I want to add a cube. So I'm just going to hit Shift A and then select this cube. I did that just to get the code in the info panel for adding a cube. I'm just going to go into the info panel down here, press Control C to copy, go right here under the comment where I left adding the cube into the scene. Just going to paste that in. We actually don't need any of these parameters. I'm going to use all the default values for all these parameters. You can experiment if you want. All right. So let's see how that works. I'm just going to delete everything from the scene, AX delete, and run the script. So now we have a script that's adding a cube as soon as we run the script. The thing that we need to do next is get a reference to this cube so we can start modifying the cube's location, right? I'm going to go into the interactive Python console down here and type in and get the currently active object. So BPY All right. So if you type that in, you'll get the currently active objects. So after you add anything into the scene, that becomes the active object. In this case, it's our cube. So I want to create a variable that's going to be named cube for a lack of a better name. And now cube, this variable cube, is referencing the currently active object, or just the cube itself, right? Also, I didn't have to name a cube exactly. It could be like cube 33, for example, and this would reference the same cube, so we can have different variables referencing the same object, right? So let me just show you an example. I'm going to use the name property on this cube and not hit enter, and change its name to my, right? So now I've changed the name of the cube. You can see the name in the outliner is updated, right? And if I go and just print out cube 33's name, right, it's going to print out the same thing because it's referencing the same object. All right, so this is what we want to do here. I'm just going to copy the cube assignment and paste it right under here. So this is exactly what we are doing. All right, next let's start modifying the location of the cube, or just find the property that is responsible for it. I'm going to go again into the interactive Python console and use my cube variable and use location as the parameter that we want to, the property that we want to edit, right? So right now the cube is located in the origin of the scene, and I can modify, for example, the location of the cube on the z-axis. So I'm going to just set that. So that's an easy way to set the location of a cube. So now we want to start adding the keyframes, right? We want to first add the first keyframe at when the cube is in the center of the scene. And we could do that by using this keyframe insert. Here we go. You see, you could press, you can type this in and press tab, and it will give you a nice, some nice information about all the parameters that you can play around with. And the first argument right here is the data path. So this is exactly what we just used right here. So this is the location. I'm just going to copy this, and I'm going to set that. And I'm going to use the frame as my frame one. So frame, actually, you know what? I'm going to not going to use the first frame. I'm going to use like, I don't know, frame 60. So you can see that it's actually being used. So I'm going to hit that. So yeah, as you can see, we have a new keyframe under frame 60. So let's do that. Just copy this into our script right here. So of course this is not 60, this should be 1, but I don't like to use just regular, just to set it to 1. I would like to kind of document this and maybe create a start frame variable, right, and set that to 1. So instead of just having 1, I'm just going to say, oh, this is not just 1, this is the start frame. So anybody who will be reading this in the future, or myself included, I would clearly understand like what I'm trying to do here. All right, so the next thing is the change the location of the cube on the z-axis. So this is exactly what we did already in the interactive Python console. I am going to just copy this over here and just set it to 5. And now we need to insert the last frame, right, last keyframe. Just going to copy this, paste it right here. Since this is not the start frame and we want to keep things organized, I should rename this to last frame. And the frame would be, I think 1, yeah, 180. Just copy that variable name right into the frame right here. And so that should set everything correctly. Now I'm gonna hit AX and then delete and then run the script. As you can see, the after the script finished running, cube popped up above the center of the scene. This is because we're setting the Z coordinate to 5. So kind of that's the last thing, the last location that's known to Blender that like we were modifying. So as soon as I start scrubbing, it's going to just pop back into the center of the scene. So I'm just going to hover over the viewport and press space to start the animation. And as you can see, the cube starts animating on the Z axis. All right, to make it more interesting, let's make a loop out of this. So we're going to go up and then down. So to do that, we would need to insert a middle keyframe. And let's just do that. I'm just going to copy the last part right here. And I'm going to leave this to 5. So that's going to be the highest point of the cube's trajectory, right? I'm going to rename this to mid frame, right? And this should be 90, right? This is the middle frame. And update the comment so we know that this is updating to the mid frame, right? And since this the last keyframe should place the cube at the center of the scene, so we need to just set this to 0, right? Let's delete everything by hitting AX and delete, and let's run the script again. I'm going to press space again, and you can see that now the cube is going up and down in a loop. To summarize, we used comments to describe our steps. We used variables to change properties of objects. And we used keyframes to animate object properties. All right, and as promised, your exercises to solidify your knowledge. Let's start with the first exercise. Change the animation, not on the Z, but on the X axis, right? Pause the video now and update the script and unpause it as soon as you're done. So I'm just going to update the comment and this property right here, the location to X, this comment right here, and this property location to X as well. Now I'm just going to delete everything from the scene and rerun the script. So let's see how that works. All right, this is exactly what we wanted. All right, and for your second exercise, let's set the starting location of the cube to -5 on the X, Y, and Z. So -5, -5, -5. And then animate the cube to X5, Y5, and Z5. So we're gonna be moving like in a diagonal line, right? So pause the video now and try this on your own. And then as soon as you're ready, unpause the video. All right, so let's just update the comment right here. As a first thing, just set this to Y and then Z, right? Just to keep things consistent, right? with what we're doing. All right, but let's just first animate this from the regular position that we're here. I'm just going to set all these to 5, and then do the same thing, just copy down here and set these to 0. All right, let's delete everything AX and then delete, run it, and run the script. And as you can see, now we're moving in this diagonal shape. So that works great. Now let's add some code that's going to modify the starting location of the cube. So let's, before we set the first keyframe, we need to modify the location, right? So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to set this to, so if I just set it to 0, 0, 0, right, this is exactly, it's going to do the exactly the same thing as it's doing right now. I'm going to again clear the scene by hitting AX and delete, run the script, and as you can see, we're doing the exact same thing as with this code or without this code, right? All right, so I said that we should start from minus 5, right? So it's minus 5, minus 5, minus 5, and save that. Okay, AX delete to clear the scene, and run the script again. And as you can see now, the cube is like traveling through the whole scene, and I didn't update the last frame. So let's do that. Let's update this thing, right? Because that's not the finishing location. All right, let's clear that and then run it again. All right, looks like it's working as we want it to, right? Another thing that I want to mention here is you don't, you can actually make this a lot, like to change the location using just one line. If you go down here in the info panel, you can see that when we're adding a cube, the location is set with this, this three numbers right here, right? This, it's called a tuple. So we can actually change this code to look like this. So I'm just gonna set, create a tuple. So it's gonna be for X, Y, and Z. I'm gonna comment this out by hitting Control forward slash. Just gonna copy this. Again, comment this out. Control forward slash. Set this to 5. And then just copy this again right here and then comment this out, control forward slash. So let's delete everything and make sure that it's gonna do the same exact thing, but just only using one line. And yes, that is exactly what it's doing. And I would personally use the more verbose way of writing this, because since you're just starting out and learning, it's gonna be best to just make sure that you understand every single line, like what's happening. You'll get to the point where you'll be comfortable with doing this, right? But for now, I would just advise you to stick with the more verbose version. All right, thank you so much for joining me in this exercise, and subscribe for more tutorials and exercises like this.